Hey guys, new video here, walking through a betrayal board from zero. Right now, this is my betrayal board after like 100 plus missions. You can see a bunch of lines, you know, it's pretty damn good. You know, farmed a lot of these good items here. So I started my Katarina, and so now she's at zero. After I kill her, all of this will turn into question marks. There'll be 10 dudes on the board instead of this 14. I'll have to rediscover them and rework my board. The strategy in the bottom right that you see right here, this is the initial strategy, making certain assumptions about next league, their value and stuff, but it's pretty safe to assume. And it's the reason I put the strategy out there, because then you can't cheat, right? Like, I can't be like, oh, Kamira's in research or Kamira's in intervention. I'm just gonna leave them there and pretend like that's like the most expensive one, right? So we set the strategy first, so we have to adhere to this. And we get lucky. If we get unlucky, it'll just take a little bit longer. So there it is right there. It That Fled and Verici in the research. And then obviously whenever you run it, you try to get It That Fled as a leader. And then the Gravitius Vagin for the good scarabs in the intervention. Obviously, with Gravitius, people are still going to be farming Barrow Chambers next league as the Divination Gilded Scarab. And then I want red lines initially. I will be doing green line testing later to get some results on how many people spawn on average. And then later on, Elrion is a necessary person for me. It might not be for you, because Elrion drops Elrion Jewelry, which could be like 20, 30C at the beginning of a league and sells very quickly. And you don't want him as a leader, because the leader is a little bit harder to spawn, especially at the beginning of the setup. So I want to drop his jewelry as much as possible. So that's it. That's strategy. We're going to get started. Okay, thanks. I hope you guys enjoy the video. It's going to be super long. Transportation, we have Tora and Jorgen, so it doesn't really matter. I'm just going to like start removing people. Okay. These will become trusted, but I'm not going to do this right now because this is like a relationship I'll have to remove later. So I'm just going to spam until I get all the question marks done. Intervention, Guff, and Yanni's. I don't want the intelligence. Well, I do, because I want to undo all this stuff, right? So this one's like 4, so it's more than that 3 on the left side. So I'm just going to get the intelligence. Unreveal all the like the question marks. Research in the first map, we have a Chimeria and we have a Yanni's. Once again, well, if I upgrade this, it'll probably be like 7 per turn, so it'll be like more, it'll be more intelligence later than it is now, so I'll do that. Fortification, we have a Jorgen, Tora, and Corel. We don't care about any of these people, so we're looking just to get a bunch of XP. So this will be 3, but this would be like 21 next turn, I think, maybe. So we're gonna upgrade him. This one doesn't really matter, but we're gonna rank up, and then we'll delete them later. And then this, oh, this safe house is already ready. Look at that. That's crazy. So I'll be able to reveal this, and we'll be able to move that guy around. If there ever is a remove, I will do it, because if it's a bad master, there's a chance that I don't know where Verici, It That Fled, Gravitius Vagin are, and they could not be on the board, so it's safer to remove if you get the option. This one doesn't matter, I'll just take the XPs. Okay, so here's the research. Verici showed up, that's really good. I'm gonna rank him up. And then we have a Guff here. Now, I don't want this trusted, because I know Guff and Haku will end up in bad houses. So I'm going to go ahead and just imprison them for the XPs. I also forgot to do this. I should have done the safe house right away, but I just forgot. Okay, so here's what's going to happen. I just did the safe house that I was talking about before. I got the Elrion. I killed him. We get some Mastermind XP. And it's very important to get that Mastermind XP, because only when the Mastermind XP is full is when you run your masters, and it allows for infinite cycling, because it's one tick down here instead of like multiple ticks, right? So you want to get the Mastermind XP, but you have to anyways, so you do this. Now, this guy goes down here, and this is actually kind of important here, because when that guy goes down there, that's how you're going to like swap. We're going to talk a little bit more about this later, and also later on, I'll talk about how to tick him out after the 3 turns once your Mastermind is out, because if you don't tick him out, this is like a little bit more advanced, but if you don't tick him out, then let's say that this was a intervention or a research, you would not get that in the next map, okay? But we'll talk about that later. Okay, another research, Chimera rank 2. Now, Guff, let's see. I know that these two will be in the same houses, the same relationship, so I don't want to make lines right now. I'm just going to see. This is why I ranked him up earlier, because he was rank 1, and now that he's rank 2, I get 21 intelligence instead of 3 intelligence. I'm just going to start interrogating him. Intervention, and this one's really important, because if you see, I got the, oh my god, I should have turned off the alerts, but it's fine. I got an It That Fled, which is part of my strategy that you see in the notepad, so I can start ranking her up, and then, but because she's in the wrong branch, I need to start ranking her down. I need to unassign her so that she can make a jump. So right here, normally if she was in research with Verici, it would be a rank up, but this is great, because sometimes on your board, these two guys don't even exist, because there's 17 masters in total, but you'll only get 14 on the board, right? So this is great, a really great start. Rank down, and then when she comes out, she will be no stars. So that's There we go. And then the next guy, Kuro, we don't really care about this guy either. Kuro and Haku, we don't want them to be trusted because once again, we know who our relationships are in the good branch, and we know that everyone else will be in the bad branch. And the bad branch, I don't want any relationships, so I'm not going to take this. And it's not a rank up or anything, which I would take in its place. So I'm just going to go ahead and imprison for a little bit of XP to possibly get more ticks towards like the question mark tiles, okay? So we have a Guff and Hillock in transportation. We know that these are bad. Hillock's not necessarily bad. Your strategy might vary if you like this guy, if you can sell him. But what I'm going to do here actually is I see an Elrion and I see a Verici and an It That Fled, right? So who am I missing? I'm missing Vajin, which I don't know if he's up here because I haven't. Sometimes you'll get an option to make a relationship between one of the undiscovered guys, but let's just like let's do this. Let's just start like deranking everyone and kicking everyone until we get all the people on the board. So this one doesn't matter. Well, actually, this one's no. We're just gonna start deranking everyone. I'll start doing that. Now this is crazy because like usually I think it's like weighted more towards like no people rather than four people. So eventually when you get board set up, like the order of operations matters. These don't really matter unless you need like swaps, right? So like the person that ends up last or the two people that end up last might have like an RNG option on the right side where it says like for example this one, right? Like I can move It That Fled to transportation. This is an assignment because as you see she has no stars. No stars means that they are unassigned. You can also see this by underneath their name, it'll tell you what branch they're in. Also yellow lines indicates it's not a relationship, but yellow lines means what branch they're in as well. So this person I don't want in transportation. I want her in I just want her in research, right? So I'm gonna leave that. Hillock. Now these are important because as you can see, I get two good options here. I get to assign an unassigned person that's bad into a bad house. And for me, the bad houses are transportation and fortification. So this is very good as an option because it locks him into transportation and he gets a rank to get more XP later. So I'm going to go and execute him, assign him there. Haku and Guff don't really matter either because they are also like bad members and so they can go anywhere. Since this guy's already like... but since I don't know who these guys are, I might need to swap to get an Elrion. No, Elrion's here. I might need to swap to get a... Gravitius or a Vajin on the board, unless one of these are them. I think what I'm going to do is... we already know that one, so I can rank him. Guff, what I'll do is I can put this guy in. We'll see what happens here before we start like trying to purposely remove people. And is that all? Oh, and then If That Fled is last. So sometimes you get like a RNG option right here. Two transportation intelligence doesn't really matter. At this point, I don't really care about ranking this up because I'll never run this house because I've already discovered who it is. And then you really don't want to fill up intelligence anymore until you like sometimes you might have to, but we can talk about that when it comes up, and then we'll focus more over here later on as well. So this one, imprisoned, I might as well just let her go. This is an important button to talk about because if you were to use this button on everything, it's just a wash. Nothing would change, and then you get another go the next time, right? So if you're ever unsure and you're really like worried about something, just let them go. It's this option and this bargain option are exactly the same. Except for this gives intelligence. So obviously, if this said like already max rank or something later on, it'd be the exact same. But for this this scenario, I'm just gonna let her go because the next time I encounter her, she has a chance to go into somewhere else that's good or like, you know, give some cool option of a relationship or whatever. So that was a longer turn. So this is very good. I have an It That Fled, a Corel, and an Elrion. So I know that my Elrion needs to be a non-master on the left side. He's on the right side right now. I know that my It That Fled is needs to be in research, so we're gonna check. Okay, so once again, we got we do have an option right here to go into a house. Once again, unassigned has chances of going into houses. Now, this is bad. There are situations where if people are the same rank, for example, if I had a +1 rank here of It That Fled and it moved here, then there is a possibility that it allowed me to like swap with same rank members, but because there's so many, it's like kind of not a good option, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm probably gonna let her go, but I wanna check later on too. So Elrion though, I know I wanna downrank Elrion, and the reason for this is because he's in a bad house, so I need to like get him out of there too. So I'm gonna derank him, I'm gonna check It That Fled just to make sure. Yeah, so it's fine. And then the reason you don't want an imprisonment is because then you wouldn't have the chance of getting her again somewhere down the line. Because if you look here, oh, also I forgot to run the safe house, guys. So this is one mistake I made before I just forgot. I should run the safe house. It's not a big deal, but it does make it so I know who this card is. And if it's a Vagin or a Gravitius, it's very, very good. Because I'll start downranking him. It'll automatically downrank him, and then, you know. So this one, because I don't want to imprison, because I want to encounter her more for more chances of putting into research, I'm going to let her, let me just make sure. Yeah, I'm just going to let her go. Okay. And then just to get into good habits right here, this Corel. So right here, this is what you're looking for with the good people. This option right here with trusted and very rarely rivalries under certain circumstances in the same house. It'll be like betrayal, right? This option is what you're looking for with the good house members. So if you encounter anyone on my notepad file, once again, if I encounter anyone in my good houses, right? Gravitius, Vagin, Verici, It That Flood, I want any relationship I can get at this point with like anyone in the good houses if it was finalized with any other person. So Verici with anyone else, you know, right here, hopefully we'll be at that flood one day with anyone else. But on the bad side, right here, these two I know are bad people because they don't fit into my strategy. So with these two, I do not want these lines. On these two houses, transportation, fortification, I absolutely do not want any relationship. So I'm not going to do this, right? This is just an example to show you what a good node would be for the good houses. Okay, so I'm gonna let, is that the last one? I'm just gonna, well, this one I can imprison. I don't really care too much about this guy. It gives, wait, imprisons for intervention. I don't know the intervention boss yet, so I will imprison for some intelligence to unreveal him. Okay, so we got research right afterwards. This is pretty damn good, because if you look right here, the Verici is a rank 2. Wow, look at that. So I'm, if I get the option for this, yep, rank up. That's pretty good. When I encounter and unreveal this tile, I will get a 1-3 white socket bench. That's the reason I have them in right here. And then to rank up, it's very... Okay, to rank up, it's very important to note why I did that first, because I would have done that anyways, but... If I had like let this guy go or imprisoned or whatever, I wouldn't have been able to rank up Richie. The way it works is that you have to have someone with the person that you're ranking up. If you spawn three people, it's a guaranteed one rank up. And then once you get rid of that third person, the way that you get it with two is usually with a rivalry, or if you have a trusted relationship, it can be like a division rank up or a complete level rank up, a complete level rank down, and some other miscellaneous options. But we'll talk about that when we get to it, because it hasn't happened yet. So once again, to drive it home, you need another person watching that person to get the rank up. And the reason is because, like, lore wise, it's like this person would see me kill Verici and Chimera, if I let him go or whatever, or do whatever, he reports back to Katarina and tells her that, like, Verici, like, died in combat or some shit. And then he's like, oh, that's, like, cool, right? So he gets a rank. That's, like, kind of lore behind it, I guess. So you can't rank up if there's one dude. If there's one dude sitting here, because a lot of the time, I promise you, when you get your board set up, you will get one member spawns. And if for example, you get a one member spawn, you'll never get the option to rank up, okay? Because there's no one watching to tell Katarina that they, like, you know, that they like died or whatever. Okay, so that's the reasoning there. Chimera, this is Chimera Elrond trusted. I know that these two are gonna, if you were doing Chimera in intervention for Solfatee Scarabs, then you would want this, absolutely, right? Like I can like make that, like if you love delving and you want this guy in intervention, then yes, you would want any relationship you can take on any part of the board. But I don't, right? Because if you look at my notepad again, he's not part of my right side strategy. So I don't want this because he's gonna be moving over here soon. And I had to remove that later anyways. So this one, it's this was a research, and I definitely want the XP for research. So I'm just going to go ahead and, I mean, he's in here right now, which I want to move him over. So I'm just going to rank him down. So this is the safe house that I missed that last time that you saw earlier. And this is an Ainsley. Now, Ainsley, I think, is like notoriously bad. But one thing I'll say as an overall strategy is that you're going to hear on guides and on YouTube videos and on Reddit posts and from your friends who is good and who is bad. It's important to have, if you have this strategy where you don't care who is in the bad houses, okay? Oh, I'm dying, Corona. So if you have someone who, like, your friends tell you or like videos tell you is bad, it doesn't actually matter if they are in the bad houses, once again. And for me, like, anything I don't care about, because the only thing I care about in the bad houses is I get this Elrion into the bad houses and not as a leader. And that's it. So this one, I have to interrogate anyways. I'm gonna interrogate, and look at that. So right now, Elrion moved to the correct side, right? Because before they were in here. And now the Elrion is in the leadership position, but it won't matter because when you downrank, they come out of leadership position. So once that happens, you know, he'll permanently pretty much stay here, but we'll talk about how to, like, you know, rank up to 3 and keep him there for as long as you want, okay, with like all the special stuff we'll talk about here. So rank down, I'm gonna go collect my reward. Here we got Verici and Toro. Now this is pretty good, because we have Verici here. We can, now here's one thing that you wouldn't do pretty much later on when you have like if that fled Verici or like Verici here if you don't care about it the fled, but you will. I can downrank this guy right here, and the reason is because he's rank 3. So if I downrank him, he won't get unassigned. He'll only get unassigned if it's like rank, if it's 1 star downrank into 0. So I can get 36 intelligence for my safe house, which I need to discover who this is, with him, right? But first, before I do that, I want to check Tora as well, because if you look right here, okay. So this is pretty good. So Tora is gem XP in research, so you might want that. So this is the situation you want with It That Fled right here, right? Because It That Fled, if you could get this, perfect. You put him in there, once you discover who this person is, you like downrank, right? But right here, it's whatever. I can get these people out for more turns later. So what I'm gonna do is, well actually, I might actually get more intelligence because it's gonna, yeah, so Tora, like from my notepad, if you look right there, I'm looking for It That Fled. So if you want Tora, this would be the perfect option for you. But for me, I'm gonna get some more intelligence, I guess, where all comes out. And then now, look at this, I can actually like take this out and get some intel. And when I think about how much intel I'm getting, this stuff, you won't have to do math all the time. Sometimes you will, but this is 36 if I interrogate, and this is like 20 mastermind, which I will eventually get by doing the houses anyways, and 9 research. Well, I kind of want more smuggle. I'm just gonna do this, right? It didn't really matter too much. With those kinds of min maxes, you shouldn't mind too much because the board's not set up yet. So when you make some mistakes when the board's not set up, as long as you follow the big rules of no relationships in the bad houses and all relationships going everywhere in the good houses, you should be fine. So getting out of here, I don't need to end this recording actually, because I just got an It That Fled intervention. And right here, you see this It That Fled right here that got assigned? This It That Fled, what I need to do is I need to downrank him, because although intervention intelligence is good, it would keep her there. Right, and letting her go would do nothing. So if I imprison her, she becomes D-ranked. So there we go, and that's it. So this one's kind of funny. This is something to pay attention to, because a lot of times, if you have someone spawning far away like this, you might forget that you have other people, because look at the minimap. Like the icons only show up when I'm in range, right? So if I were here, I might think if I'm not paying attention, that's only Hillock. And if it was dependent on later on that you need to go talk to the other two people to get like a better option, you would miss out on those better options. So always make sure you know like how many people are spawning, okay? So for this, it's I got Chimera, I got Haku, and I got Hillock. And so the first thing that goes through my mind is that I know that all three of these dudes would be in the bad houses, and I know that this is a transportation encounter, so I'll never feed intelligence, right? Which feeding intelligence means clicking on interrogate usually. I'll never feed intelligence in here unless it was like the very beginning of my board. So let's just take a look at these options. This is fine. I mean, we can rank up to feed intelligence into here when they get relationships. So that is fine. This one is +1 rank, and then, oh, so this is good, you see, because this option, when I execute him, he gets a rank and he gets moved into a house. Transportation is right here, and when Chimera moves into transportation, that is a full house, okay? And what I mean by that is that once the house is full with 5 people total, Yanni's as a leader, and then Haku, Guff, Hillock, Chimera as subordinates, then no one else can get assigned there. And that's kind of what you need later on when you have like the two dudes in here that are good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go like this, and as you see, full house over here. This is like looking okay so far. Once again, I need to get Elrion out here, but let's just keep moving on over here. This Hillock right here is a, oh, this is good, because look, once again, we know that Hillock's a bad member. Wait, actually, no, never mind. Sorry, he's not unassigned. My bad. I take everything I said back. So right here, Hillock, if he was unassigned, this would be good because it would move him to transportation, but he's already there. So this one doesn't really matter. Wait, where's the Jorgen though? Wait, Hillock was... Oh, it just like switches these two. So this one doesn't matter at all because it's the good ones. There is one instance that you would want to swap two members, right? Once again, it swaps if it's like the same rank for this option. The one instance you might want to swap is when you get a billion lines everywhere and you might have like more lines here or here. You might want to swap to get more visibility on your lines. It's a very one-off, and you'll see what I mean later when when you can't see shit and you have to like move things around maybe to like get better vision, okay? But right now, for now, it doesn't matter. I can click this, or I can click on the escape, right? If I click on this, these two swap. If I click on this, it's a wash, nothing changes. Doesn't really matter. So I'm just gonna let them go. We got transportation here. We got Yanni's, we got Haku, we got Guff. We know that it's transportation once again, so we never feed intelligence into it if we can help it, unless it's to get a relationship. We have like rank ones here, so there's gonna be some plus one ranks. Once again, three people guarantees a rank up. And then these, I don't really care about. These are not part of the people. These are not the people that are part of our strategy. So for this, if I need to rank up, I can feed intelligence to get this cap, but that'll come anyways. So I'm just gonna start ranking up this. I'm gonna start ranking up. Start ranking up this, and then this guy. Oh, okay. So see, this sometimes happens, and this is very important because early on you can get an easy swap into the correct house. Later on, if you ever want to move, you might be able to do this. But in this case, it's a swap between Verici and Haku, and I don't want that because Verici is where he needs to be, and then Haku is he can stay over here, right? So for this, I mean. This one isn't like that important. I might get some intelligence here just because he's rank 3, so it's 36, and that would allow me to maybe like insta feed intelligence to here if I need to, right? But it's not really that big a deal. It might make him unranked though, like if I do it. So actually this one I'm just gonna let go just to like be more, keep it simple, right? Hey guys, we got an intervention here. We got Ainsley, we got Tora, we got this. Okay, now this one I don't want because this is an assignment of Tora. One note, don't be confused when the unassigned people get put like randomly here. It doesn't mean they're actually like, alongside these houses. What this means is just there's no space. Like the one thing to note is that the UI is complete dog shit, okay? And it's only gonna get worse. So basically just look at the stars and look for like no assignment underneath their name. So so don't get confused by that. So this Tora could move to intervention. We don't want that because we want her in the bad houses. This Ainsley is intervention. We don't want that. We want her in the bad houses. Right now this is full, so we're only looking at placements in fortification. And then the Corel is here, so we're gonna downrank him because he's already been assigned here. Yo, thank you Wonder, appreciate that for 4 billion years. This Corel we don't want in here, we want to move him over, so or we want to remove completely, so we're just gonna downrank him and now he's out of there, okay? And then this one we have, let's see, do I just want intervention talent? I'll take some intelligence, I guess. This person intervention intelligence without, it's more intelligence actually, because like once I start putting more people in, it'll kick him out, so we just do that. Oh, okay, recording. So this is Verici that fled. They're in the good room. So hopefully what happens here is that I can like maybe when I click on one of these guys, it'll be like a trusted relationship, because you really need a line between the two people that you want in the same house. So we got really lucky here. We got Verici with the It That Fled. So right here, look at that. It plus one rank to It That Fled, it moves to research. Fantastic, right? So we definitely want to do that, but we always check just so you can see the options, right? Because like if you were to like cancel this guy, like dude, like this would be a wash. This execute does nothing, let go would do nothing, imprison would like get you faster to discovering this card, but you remove them anyways. So your option is It That Fled plus one rank and it moves to research, which is the correct thing, okay? And this is important because you will make a lot of mistakes early on with your order of operations, okay? Because imagine this was two people that could be rivalries. If you remove the wrong one, you can't rival up the, or you can't rank up the other guy, but we'll talk about that later. So we go ahead and assign him, and we're looking pretty good. The Verici here is, so right here, I kind of want to speed this up. I can either take a, I don't care about the white sockets right now, so I can take 14 or 36 intelligence. If I downrank him, nothing really happens, right? Because he's still... It's important to note that with the stars, he's still assigned to the house. So I'm going to go ahead and get some intelligence so I can get rid of that card. Research, and we got an It That Fled. Now, one thing to note is that in here, what's going to happen is that when a safe house spawns, it can never spawn the master. So it tries to spawn one of these. Like, for example, if a fortification spawns later, it will never be Elrion to first spawn. It'll never be Yanni's to first spawn. It will be one of the followers. If there is no follower, you can't spawn that safe house, which is why we'll talk about the foothills later. In this scenario, we got an it that flies as a follower because we can't spawn this guy. And so now we have an option of moving it to transportation, which we don't want. Or we can get some intel, but we don't want that because she's rank 1. And by moving her to rank 0, that's a deassignment. Then you have to do it all over to put her back, right? Which at this point in the board, not a big deal, but we will just let her go. In here as well, one thing to note is that the leader can rarely spawn with the safe house follower, and also in other houses and in this house, it has a higher chance of spawning if there is lines, okay? But like, for example, if I did a transportation, fortification, or intervention, I wouldn't get this this leader because there's no lines, okay? But you'll get lines, a lot of lines later on. So this one I'm gonna let go. Once again, this button is just a wash, it doesn't do anything, right? So the board stays exactly the same, given that you tick one forward, because every encounter, every spawn is one tick forward for a turn, and it's not a turn based on how many people spawn, it's a turn based on a branch spawning. Mention, and we have 3 people here. Once again, these are all bad people, and then we look, you can see the stars, the rankings, when you mouse over. This one, we have intervention, we don't want that. Corel has intervention, we don't want that. This one is a +1 ranked Tora or intelligence. I'm just gonna do this. I guess I can fill up intervention, right? I can just fill up intelligence. These options, so I'm gonna talk a little about what happens on the left side and what happens on the right side real quick. Left side will always be like an interrogation where you try to lock them up pretty much, okay? The right side can have these RNG encounters, like maybe it says drop some currency, like depending on who it is, right? It's like the options are different. Like Ainsley may drop initial Veiled mod, like there's all kinds of other things that could happen right here that are random. Sometimes even if you get one person to spawn, it'll give you a random chance of getting a line, a green line to someone else, right? It's like very rare, but it does happen over time. So just keep in mind that sometimes if this happens, you can go ahead and take that, because if I were to let her go, if this said like nothing or whatever, then I could let her go. But because of this, it doesn't do anything else, so I could also bargain. So if these two options, let go and bargain, are exactly the same in terms of XP and relationships and ticks and all that stuff, then what's going to end up happening is you should take this, because like it's better, right? Overall, if it's the same, but this one gives you a veiled item early on to make your crafting bench better, you should take this one. So I'll do that and see, it's a wash, nothing happens. By himself in a transportation. Now these, later on you'll find that when one person spawns, it's a super easy decision like 99% of the time, okay? So I talked to Haku, and look, I can get the intelligence, or I can get even more intelligence, or I can just let him go. At this point, thinking back, I don't want to make the video more complicated or longer, so I probably should have just taken intelligence to like get more masterminds, so I can lock out the mastermind, so you can see what that looks like, right? I should have done that in the video. Okay, so this is a really good one. I did a research, and splinters. So It That Fled and Verici are both pretty good, right? So this is an order of operations thing. In the future, when this happens, you're gonna think of it like this, right? Remember, you need one person watching to rank up. So if I were to do this and talk to this guy and rank this guy up, for whatever reason, right? I know who it is now. Or if I, in this case, I would imprison to get him out, okay? If I did this, I wouldn't be able to rank up both, because once I rank up one, there's no one watching the last guy. But if I go here and I want It That Fled up, right? Given that this is like a full board and everything, I'll rank her up, right? And then if I talk to him, okay, these guys don't have like a relationship for the two, but like they will later for sure, okay? In later on instance, you would have a rank up here, okay? But is this a betray? Wait, hold on, what's this one? Is this a betray? Oh, special. Okay, this is getting too complicated because it's special. Like this, I'll talk about the RNG thing earlier, right? Because I don't have, there is a chance. Wait. Yes, this is actually amazing. Okay. Here's, let me calmly explain this. So the Verici, this betray button is a rivalry. Okay. Most of the time, when people are doing relationships, they wait for a text to say rivals, okay? So this does not say rivals. If I look over here with this guy, they're in the same house, this does not say rivals, right? and this does not say betrayed. So this is the special scenario where it's the follower, like I said before and early in the video, of the follower betraying the master. So, and it's also important because this is like a 3-in-1, because not only do I remove Riker, if you look on my board and you look on my notes right here, our initial strategy, our initial strategy is we need Gravitius and Vajin in intervention. Now, I don't have Gravitius on the board, and I don't have Vajin anywhere on the board, right? They're not there. There's only one unrevealed dude. Now, that could be a Gravitius or a Vajin, but then how would I get the other guy, right? I wanna keep spawning in more dudes. So by removing this person, there's a chance that, like, you know, the Vajin and the Gravitius move in, right? Because, like, there's 17 members, 14 on the board eventually. So for this, I will betray, and let me drive home this point, because this is something that took me like 3 or 4 days before I realized that this was the case. And that is, betray is always a rivalry line, okay? Even if it already exists, you might get this, but in all other cases, betray button creates a red line between the person you're clicking it from and the person that it tells you what's happening, okay? And if they get removed, then there's gonna be a thing. Okay, so watch. This is gonna get them out of here, and then they're gonna move up. So I'm gonna betray here, right? I betray, and you see that? Like, the betray is always right, but he got removed. There are times when you'll betray and they won't get removed, right? And that's a red line. And now this could be, like, the dream scenario would be, like, Gravitch's Vagin right here. Okay? That makes sense? Okay, so that's what I do there. So this is an intervention, Ainsley and Carell. Now, what you should realize is that a little bit more advanced tech is to, like, in your mind, you should always be thinking, intervention research are feeds, right? XP feeds when your board is set up. And what I mean by that is, because I know that this is a spawn-in of intervention, I know that these people can, like, feed XP into the house, right? Now, this is messed up because it's not, like, the correct members yet, and these guys aren't ranked up or anything, and there's no lines or anything. So we're gonna take a look at these two, and yeah, so this one I don't want here, so I'm gonna go ahead and take this person out. I still have to discover that. And then this person has two or three. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I guess I'll go with the three. Okay, so this is a one-man in fortification. Once again, one-mans are really easy to decide on. You click on them. We know this is a bad house, bad member. But this is, like, interesting to know, right? Because Carell can move to fortification, this is just like a swap, but there's a trusted line, okay? And you might be tempted to do this, but because I know both these members mentioned for the trust relationship, these are bad houses, okay? So I do not want that line now, so I just let them go. Fortunately, it didn't spawn with anyone else, so usually once your board is set up, if you get one man's in the good houses, because this and intervention are the good houses, it's kind of sad, because, like, unless you get a good RNG option, you're not going to get much out of it. So this one, oh, good RNG option, oh, okay, so let me talk a little bit about this option, because, like, you might, if you scuff this, it might be hundreds of junes before you get it back. Okay. In each house of the good houses, you absolutely want relationships between the two members that you've chosen, okay, if you're doing this strategy. And so now, I have gone ahead and in my most important, most money-making house, I have established a trusted relationship, which is going to be a green line appearing between Verici and it that fled. And then eventually you can make that rivalries, and you'll never make it neutral. But if you scuff this, if you somehow scuff this, or later on you make them neutral, you might not get it again for, like, a lot of June. So be careful with that, okay? So when you see relationships in between the members here that you don't have, you definitely want it no matter what, okay? So we bargain, and you'll see a green line appear. Boom, and now we have this relationship, which means that it's easier for, like, later on. Let's say that let's say that this spawns again, right? Because she's a follower, she has to spawn. I believe it's a higher chance now, right? Because even if this wasn't here, I believe the safe house master can come in very, very rarely. Okay, but this is so good. It's actually so good. Okay, Tora and Ainsley here. Tora's in the wrong is in the wrong house. I'm gonna go and pull her out. Ainsley imprisoned or intervention intelligence. Yeah, I'll just do that. Let's get a couple, because next time I get her, I want at least, like, some of those unassigned guys out, because what's gonna happen is I could get, like, a removal thing later, whereas if they're in prison, I can't spawn them, right? Spawn, we have Kabiri rank 1, Yanni's rank 2. Once again, transportation, we don't want to feed XP if we can help it. And so we look at him. This guy is 10, what is this? This is plus 1 rank, which is fine because we can feed it, which we can use him to feed XP into the research and intervention. Chimeria, does he have anything good? Oh, okay, so this one right here, you might be tempted to make a rivalry here, but they're going to be in the same side. So let me explain this as if you wanted Chimeria. Let's say you have this board and you want Sulfity Scarabs, so you're eventually moving over here. Then in this case, you would absolutely betray, because that would make a red line between Yanni's and Chimeria, and then when you eventually downrank Chimeria, he's going to shift over, and now you have a red line between a good member in a good house to a bad member in a bad house, right? But in our scenario, once again, looking at our notepad priorities, this is a bad person for us, for me. So I am not going to do that, and I don't want any intel. I'm just going to let him go. Now the Yanni's here. Okay, 16 transportation. I don't really want this. Once again, going backwards, I could do this and then like shift stuff more around, but I'm trying to keep it like really simple. But going back, I would have done this so I can like fill this up faster to show you what this button looks like and to see what happens when you get 100% and that leader would only take once. Okay, but that's for later. Okay, so we got research here. Very, very good, because it's both people here. So now let me just like do a quick glance. Like you can like pause the video here, and I've moused over all of them, so you should be able to know what to do here, like as a general strategy, okay? And you can like kind of like work out in your mind if you made the right choice. So, and what the answer is you need to rank up If That Fled. You're guaranteed right now. You're guaranteed a pure stone, right? However, you want to also rank down Verici, because you know that since Verici is the boss, right? When you rank him down, If That Fled becomes the boss, and that would be two pure stones, okay? Did anyone get it right? Yeah? Okay, so for example, right here, it doesn't... Once again, because this interrogate option will always be here, it doesn't really matter what you do. But since I'm like unsure a little bit about the full lines here, I'm just going to go ahead and play it safe. And I know that by doing this first, and then by looking at her, because remember, I can always do Richie at any time to drag him out of the leadership position. I don't need to do him right now, because what if Rin had something crazy that would change? And okay, there's nothing really crazy here. It's just intelligence. And I don't want to move her to research. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to interrogate her to get a little bit more, right? Wait, hold on. Verici is going to be 7, wait, it's 10 times 3. So here's what we have to, might do a little bit of math. 10 times 3 is 30. 30 plus, what happened to the thing? Okay. If you ever like scuff this like this, you can do this. You can talk to other people to see this. Okay, let me talk about this as well. Once again, the UI is completely scuffed. Sometimes to see an area of the board, you can just talk to the other person, okay? You can just do that. So Rin covers here, but if I want to like see some stuff over here, I can like talk to him and see clear over here. But that's not neither here nor there. Okay. Now we know we have to downrank him, but here it doesn't really matter, because we want to leave her unassigned. Okay. So we don't want to move her to research. We want to leave her unassigned, because if we imprison her, it is lost XP, because Verici is going to give us 30. And if we do this, then it's like 3 over, it doesn't matter. So if she's like let go or whatever, then what's going to happen is like we can encounter her again for maybe an assignment in, what is this house? Fortification. Okay, so yeah, let's just play it safe. We're going to do this, downrank. See that? If That Fled moves up, that's fantastic. He is not unranked, because if you look right here, he's ranked 2. Okay, so he's not in danger. And then we can talk to her, and this one doesn't really matter. Oh! Ah! Ah! Okay, and so yeah, that was the right order of operations, because we got RNG'd, right? You don't always get this. This is called the RNG option. And so since we did that, right, we have a line. So Rin and Verici are trusted, and that's very important, because that's another green line, right? Wait, hold on, wait, did I already click on it? Wait, why are they trusted already? Wait, why are they trusted? No, this bugged. Why are they trusted already? Wait, what? Oh, it's a UI! Okay, this is exactly what I'm talking about. The UI is so scuffed. This green line is actually running from Verici to It That Fled behind the Rin. And when this happens later on, when you have like 50 lines everywhere, you're gonna get triggered. It's like really annoying, okay? So that's what I'm talking about with the UI. So yeah, so I would obviously do this anyways, right? Like even if you see the lines that might not make sense and you can like toggle around clicking on different members to see it, remember, just go for the relationships, and in the betrayal situation, the way I'm not gonna explain it until later, it's way too complicated. Let's just click on this. Okay, so as you can see, I bargained and she's still unassigned, so I can encounter her later. And then she now has an extra line, and this is what you're going for. Remember, good houses, lines from them everywhere. Bad houses, no relationships, right? Unless it's a relationship to the person in a good house. All right. So this is Ainsley, Corel, and Rin. I'm gonna mouse over here. You can see one's ranked, which means she's assigned to a house, and we have two unranked. And so what I'm gonna do is, this is a intervention. So when I click on them, let's just like see what's going on. She's right here. We're gonna want more intelligence. So I'm automatically gonna just release this person, or not release. I'm gonna interrogate for intelligence so I can discover that card. This one, I don't want her to move here. What does this one do? Let's see. This one is intervention as well. I'm just gonna imprison them so I can get the Verici out real quick. Right, and then this one is, okay, see, this is like the RNG option on the right side, and then we have Ainsley and Hillock trusted, but because we know that Ainsley or Hillock or anyone else might get removed later, we don't want this relationship, right, because they're in bad houses. So this one I can either let go or do this. This is like 82, I can just do that, it's fine, right? Okay, hold on a second. Okay, I didn't realize that was a mistake, because I was trying to hurry up the video. The Verici was in the queue, so I took out the Verici, so now my research house is delayed by a couple turns. That was a mistake. I should have let her go. Okay, so that was a mistake right there, but we like, now you know why. That's gonna be super easy. It's a bad house. We have a Jorgen and Rin trusted, but once again, we don't want that. Also, another thing that you could do is, like, if you want to try out what happens when you do a lot of lines, you can absolutely do that and remove the relationships later. You will be able to remove relationships between the bad houses, okay? But for this, I'm just like playing it really safe, and I don't want this. I don't want intelligence, bad houses. I'm gonna let them go. 79x. Nico, nya, nya. No, thank you. No, thank you. Okay, what is your price? I offered, you give me counteroffer. What is your root price? That's how weeps say your. Do you guys want to see what I have for my guy yet already? This is my Archmage set, by the way. I don't know which one of these are good. So I just bought a bunch of them because they were really cheap. I'm going to go with Brand Loyalty, Grand Design. And for some reason, I can't find Megalomanias with like three of them. Do you still want Fluid Motion? I'm okay, TY. I think I got two, right? Fluid Motion, 1% all Ellie. Because I have like multiple forms of damage, you know? Wait, why? Okay, this guy's 250 though. Hatred has increased. Or that was like, ooh. Oh, it has multi. Wait, I want to buy. What is? I didn't say that his had multi as well though. His has multi, 24 multi during any fast effect, but it requires level 48 though. Yeah. You don't crit though. Well, I could crit though. That's the thing. I could crit though. Right. Yo. when I get crit shrine. Alright, yo, what about this one though? Yo, what about this one though? What is it, sir? Hey, sir. Sir, I'm gonna have to put this guy on ignore. It's like, dude. Come on, dude. Come on, dude. Jesus Christ. Buying HH for a shrine? No, sometimes I do get base crit though. I do get base crit though sometimes. And the way that I get that is, you get certain things. Okay, this is, I don't think I'm gonna be able to get it. So what I need to do is I just need to lower the percentages. I need to go to 5, 4, oh yeah, look at this one. No? Oh, he responded. Wait, is it actually a requirement, a level requirement? Level 40, hell yeah, dude, 88. Yeah, the Nico. He responded. Pogger's hands. Wait, do I have Pogger's hands? Pogger's hands is my new favorite emo, dude. Let's just make sure. It's not okay. Okay, how come it doesn't have How come it doesn't have catalysts on it though? Is it because it comes from a divination card or something? Because like, dude, why would you double crop without the catalyst though? It's like, it kind of like triggers me, you know? That doesn't have catalyst. Also, I need a skin. Can't play without a skin, right? Sometimes I pull out so hard, I rip the skin. Yeah, where's it though? Someone stole my belts. Someone stole my unique belts. Oh wait. Brandis or? I need a mother's parting gift actually. You know, like mother. What's like, guys? I need a cool belt skin actually. We can't play without cool belt skin. Like we're no half measures when we're twinking. I think the coolest. The coolest unique belt is. Is it a Oxium Perpetual? No. Is it a Soul Tap? Soul Tap is pretty cool. Sunblast, Feast Bind. What does that look like? You know, Mother's Parting Gift is pretty insane for a new. That's pretty edgy. Famine Bind's pretty cool too. Oxium. Is it a Crystal Belt now? Yeah, let's go with Oxium. 2C. Okay, here we have a Jorgen in the fortification. And we see that he has a Jorgen and Guff become trusted. We don't want that because we don't want any relations in the bad houses. We don't want to fill up this house either, so we're just going to let this guy go. Here we have a Torah intervention, and then the Torah has 6 intervention intelligence. I'm going to go ahead and take this one because what's going to happen is I'm going to fill up the safe house and reveal this card. And I'm actually going to run this safe house now that I filled the XP. And the reason I'll do this, well, I can't do it here, is because if you look right here, you see how it's like 2 out of 3. If I don't run it here and I go do the research that's up there, what's going to end up happening is that I'm going to have to go to the foothills to take it, or else I'm not going to get my 3 encounters next map. I'll only get 2 because what's going to happen is, if you look right here, show investigation, right? Once I run this, the leader gets imprisoned, and then there will be something random here. Now, it might fill, actually, in the case of a full board when you're fully set up, that situation, you have to go to the foothills if it's the last one, but we'll explain that a little bit later. Okay, now we have a research here. This is the last encounter, and this is actually pretty good because if you look right here, we have some good options. We have a Ricci, we have an It That Fled, so we know that Ricci, you know, we might want to rank him up. Ainsley, what do we have here? Nothing too much here. So Ricci, we rank him up. All right, so we can guarantee that. So now we have like 2 stones. We have like Verici here. We look at the It That Fled. Nothing happens here. We're not going to derank her anyway. And then right here. Now, this one's interesting because I know that like I don't really want her. I need to like take someone off the board. So for this, because she doesn't give any real XP because she doesn't have a rank, I'm just going to let It That Fled go. So execute's like pretty much the same thing. And then let's take a look. So this drops a veiled item. And that's pretty cool, I guess, because like you can, in the early league, you can't unveil that. Once again, 3 XP is like nothing, especially right now since we don't have our board set up. So I'm just going to go ahead and drop a unveiled item. My loot filter is really strict right now, so I won't see that item, but if you take a look, like you can unlock your crafts pretty fast. All right, and here we saw I'm clearing the safe house, and I have a Vagin, which is great because look right here. This is exactly who I want on the board. So now the only person that's really missing is Gravitius, which means that we'll have to remove probably like Rin, Ainsley, like Haylock, maybe like, well, Corral, like one of these people that's like unassigned. Hopefully we get an option for remove because the next person that comes on the board has a high chance of being Gravitius, and then we're almost done with the board. So here we interrogate so we can get a little bit more master intelligence. And this is also important because like if this fills up 80, I need to like actually do one more safe house. So just to make it a little bit harder for myself, I'm actually gonna like do this one. I'll fill up the research safe house, and then that way I'll be able to fill up mastermind. Once again, the mastermind is important to have a full bar, but you don't run it because then once there's a full bar, the imprisoned leader, when you run the safe house, is gonna be out on the next turn. And then what's 0.5? Wait, exalt today is 144, so 72. And 73. Highlight my message. Dude, look at that fruit bang. Look at that fruit bang. This guy's name is Colonel Squirt. Colonel Squirt. Nice, dude. 2123. Hey, isn't Squirt like a drink? It's like a lemon lime drink, right? But I put that in. So I can forego the, you know what I could do? Where's my lightning golem? Hold on a second. I don't have a lightning golem, do I? Yeah, I don't think I have a lightning golem. Because where'd he go? Oh, the lightning golem's in the bossing set. Okay. So what I can do is I can put this here, I can take out the increased duration, and I can put this on, and I can put that on, okay. And then, let's see, is everything else on? Yeah, everything else is on, right? Zealotry, Wrath, Clarity, Precision, and then, okay. So now, if you look, I have I don't have that much mana, right? 6,000. So I only have 90,000 Stormbrand damage. That's pretty bad, isn't it? However, let's try some maps. And do I have any? Let's try some like canyon maps. I can just roll some canyon maps. Let's do 6 canyons. Don't reserve mana. Wait. Why should I reserve mana on Archmage? I'm trying it out, dude. You think it's gonna be bad? Ooh, we got Beyond though. Like, let's try with no Beyond to see, like, just regular juice, right? Reflect, Hexproof. Yeah, that's fine. Less AoE. Alright, these are fine. Like, I know how the Archmage works, but what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to, like, see the juice with but what I'm trying to show is you don't need damage, right? You don't need that much damage. I know how this works. I'm testing something out. Because I lose damage, but do you know what I gain? I'm doing this on purpose, by the way. Let's see, what's like the cool Herald of Ass? Sun Prism? Or, to really show it off with AoE, Dragon Hunter. Wait. Okay, so, now. Dude, I think this is like so cool though. Look at this thing, hold on. Like, look at this shield though. Yo, look at this shield though. Isn't that crazy? I just came up with this idea. Okay, so I'll explain really quick so everyone's on the same page, and then we can progress from there. This is my mapping. Right now, this is my mapping set, okay? I forego 12% pen on the helmet. Right? This is my bossing helmet. Damage penetrates 12%. I'm not converting to cold because I can't fit in resist. Then for mapping, look at this. Where's my dash? Look at this dash. Like, are you kidding me? Look at this. That's like so good for mapping, right? So I lost damage there. The two gem swaps are a lightning jolt for tick rate and then a righteous fire for 28% more damage. And then I switched that for just a super juice percentage dash distance and cooldown recovery. And then, for I switch out my wand, right? So look at the mana. If I don't have Herald of Ass, like just as an example, look at this. I have 9.3k mana, but my mapping weapon has 8.2k. And not only that, I reduce it even further by purposely putting on Herald of Ass, which I don't have on the other set. And then instead of chain is for mapping, right? So look at that, 76 average damage. Chain goes in instead of crit multi. And the Bottled Faith is for mapping, which I didn't use for those elders because I didn't need it. And that's probably gonna go in instead of like either like rummies or like Quicksilver Flasks, right? So that's like the swap right there. And the reason I'm doing this is because I wanna like specialize, right? Like I think that maybe there's a way in the future where I make builds and they have like two variants. They have a mapping variant and a bossing variant. So then like in the most dire cases where like all the builds suck, you can just play one build, you know, instead of specializing. Those are kind of cool. Okay, let's go ahead and do these maps. Let's put in some scarabs too, like Breach, Harbinger. What else is good? What else is good? Brandis and Legion, right? Do I have Sextons? Yeah. And let's put on like, I don't know, Alba? Is Alba good? I have Overflowing Riches. Let's get like a couple Froggies. I'm kind of jazzed about this build though. It's kind of cool. So here's what I'll do, right? I'll show you a map with this mapping setup, and then I'll do one with like the bossing setup, and it should be a pretty huge difference, you know? We'll take this out, start casting. Take out power charge. Wait, are you supposed to take power charges though? Really? I gotta hit the mirror. Okay, so this is the clear with the mapping set. As you can see, I don't really need damage right now. I might need damage later on, right? Look at this. Whoa, a 6 white Rampage gamer? That's big, dude. That's big. So as you can see, the clear is pretty nice. It's the chain and everything, and the Herald of Ass. I don't need the more damage, right? A lot of people are worried about damage, but I think damage comes last once you have like the mechanics down, you know. So this is, it's pretty good, right? Especially this distance, this dash distance is insane, right? And I still get my and then look, 3.9k, like basically a 3.9k molten shell, really nice. You know, I wish it worked with, you know, they should differentiate arcane cloak. And you know what they should do? They should allow it to work for dots too. Cause like what's the difference between like steel skin? But if you take out the damage of molten shell, right? There's no difference between arcane cloak, molten shell, and arcane cloak, right? Because like molten shell, like, yeah, maybe explodes for some damage and stuff, and maybe like arcane cloak gives you a little bit extra damage, which you won't notice. But actually, it'll give you a lot of damage. But it's like, they're all like hit damage, you know. They should give arcane cloak the chance to, what was that, they should give it the chance to negate, what's it called, dot damage, right? Are you a real method boy now? Maybe, I don't know, dude. Maybe it's still one big debate, you know. I'm waiting for the fog. I don't like to lose the fog. Like, dude, I don't know. This build is like pretty good, dude. Like, I'm really enjoying the build because like, if I play with one hand, I never hit a Hera. If I don't hit like any of my flasks, okay, I just run around, and it's like anti RSI too, because I have Stormbound on S, D, E, left click, and so it's like four buttons to combat the RSI. It's like pretty good, actually. And you don't really, it's like too much damage. Because of, and the reason for that is because like, if you ever run into it on a normie map, because currently the brand loyalty is super bugged, right, in your favor. So if you ever run into a scenario where you're like, you know what, I wish I had some single target there, what you would do is like, you wouldn't post on Reddit and complain, or you wouldn't like trade for better gear. You would just brand recall on top of a boss, and then you get like, you know, a bunch more damage. And yeah, like my gear right now is like pretty expensive, but mostly it was cannibalized a little bit. Like I had to I lost two mirrors this morning, because the reason I lost two mirrors this morning is not because I needed any gear, but because I didn't want to swap out a three node for a one node on my Scion for voices to test it out and put it back. So I was like, there's nothing to mirror anymore. So let me just buy another one node voices so I don't have to swap for testing purposes. That's like how lazy I've gotten this league, right? So it's like kind of, congrats on Lily making it. Hey, thank you, man. Thank you. Yeah, Lily's pretty excited. Lily's pretty jiggy jazz. I ran to RSI this league. How do you recover from it most efficiently? I don't know about recovery. You need to ask a doctor, dude. I'm not like a doctor. So I don't know, but I can make a YouTube video on how to not encounter RSI in the first place when you're playing, like when you're farming. All right, if you're farming a lot, I think I have like a good strat for not getting RSI. It just relies on making sure that your left and right hands are like balanced between the keys, right? Like you shouldn't be pushing most of the keys with your right hand. Well, most people push most of the keys when they're farming with the left hand, right? But you should split it between the two, and then rest your arm as well, so that you're not like carrying the weight of your arm on. Ooh, Exalti, first map of the day is always Exalti, right? Like, don't carry the weight of your arm on your shoulder either. Okay, let's see. I thought the method thing was just high effort irony. Wait, are you actually sad that I joined method? I'm not sad. I was like, at first I was like a little bit unsure. I was unsure for like a month. So you can ask MP. I consulted MP. I was like, hey MP, I got this thing to run by you, dude. And then I was like talking about it with some people, and then I just like, it turned out that it wasn't what I thought it was. You know what I mean? Like, there weren't the, I was scared of restrictions, but there were no restrictions really. So yeah. So basically, long story short, it just like made sense, right?
Hi, Lily.
Oh, Lily's just playing with her thing. So, yeah. Are you actually sad? I mean, it doesn't change anything, right? All right. If I'm like fist my ass, or like like, oh, take it, boy. Right? If I'm doing like stuff like that on stream, there's like no change to the stream, actually. Besides being a complete dirty sellout and drinking grapefruit juice on stream. Do you have a POB? For what? This setup? Well, okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make a POB for the mapping setup, and then a POB. Okay, I'm gonna have a POB for the mapping setup and the other setup, okay? Okay, now that we're a professional gamer, see, look, it's changing the stream for the better. I was wrong. I lied. It is changing the stream, but for the better, because now I'm more helpful gamer, okay? Because I'm a professional. I'm a business professional now. Okay, so watch this. I'm gonna do a new. So let me import. Let me just do slash delve. I do slash delve to reset the zone so it's updated. And then we import. If you wanna know how to import, you can always do exclamation mark import. Delirium. Delirium. And this character's name is Mage. Okay, so this one, tree import, generate, share with pastebin. So exclamation mark commands add. Archmage, right? So, this PO. Wait, what the? Oh shit! No! Oh man, dude, it didn't paste. It didn't copy the pastebin. It copied my message. Not like this. It at coronal squirt. No. Hold on. Edit Archmage. No. That's my that's my trade message that got copied. Not like this. Okay, mapping variant, not like this, dude. Okay, this is the mapping variant, and then I gotta import, and then now what I gotta do is I gotta put on the different gear. No, I'm gonna edit it, dude. Hold on, I'm editing it, dude. Done. You guys can't do that anymore. Don't message that guy. that is soul, dude. That Hero of the Vast is mine. It's in my weapon. So now I'm gonna change to my see, and then also one thing I want to consider in the future once I have all my points is I want the least amount of clicks possible, right? Like I don't want something where I have to click a shit ton of times. So the mapping variant is gonna be obviously this, but it's gonna be with like the ink duration here, and then it's gonna be this helmet. Now this helmet's an easy swap because I made it so that you see how I have the green up here. I made it so that all I gotta do is switch over these two gems. I don't need to switch over these two. And another thing I could do is I can buy extra gems so I don't have to swap at all, right? But I'm kind of lazy right now. So I put this on, and then this bottle fit, I guess the best would be like to put it instead of the Quicksilver. And so this is the bossing. Oh, and then increase crit for the chain. And that's, and then, well, and then refund this. And I go for like this, the juice right here, right? And then, so we do that. And let's now go back. So in case you guys didn't know, if you are ever trying to refresh your POB, like if I made this change right here and then I imported, I'm pretty sure my character would be the same. It wouldn't like upload your changes, but if you just change any zone whatsoever, any loading screen, then when I import, so I go back, new, import, and then now, it should be updated, right? Delirium, mage, items, and so let's check items, and yeah, and it changed. Okay, good. There we go. So now, let me edit this, edit, and then let me generate the pastebin. Share with pastebin. Okay, that's not actually copied it. And then this one, this is bossing variant. How do you spell variant? Is it like that? Updated as of 5:56. So Richie Research drop some currency, and we don't want to imprison him because he'd be rank 1. I kind of want a rank 3 for my own gear, so we're gonna drop some currency, and that's it. This is intervention Vagin Corell. We know that Vagin, wait, he's unranked right now. We want to get him in there. We really want to move into intervention, so we rank him up, and then Corell, we want to get him out, so we're gonna imprison Corell there. And so now we have one person in a good house. Okay, we have Transportation Hillock by himself, not very good. You know, I need to start like removing people to get the Gravitius on the board since he's not on the board yet. So I'm gonna start imprisoning, and then I need a little bit of that as well. So, there we go. Nope, no friends. Okay. So this, okay, recording. This one's interesting because we have a trusted relationship, and this one I'm actually going to do because I know that I can play for a long time, and I want this trusted because I know that Ainsley is going to eventually end up in one of these houses, and that's like a cross relationship. Getting this green line is very good, so I'm going to go ahead and do this. Right, and he was the only one there, so we didn't have to like check order of operations. So Vagin just spawned. I know that this can be a rank up probably because it's three people guarantees a rank up. That's pretty good right here. And then Rin and Hillock are unassigned, so we check for any assignments. No assignments there. No assignments there. So like here, it doesn't really matter. I guess if I imprison both of them, I get more chances of the other dudes. So yeah, let's go ahead and do this, right? Okay, so for this one, it's a Haku single on a transportation here, and so I'm gonna remove him because it's like very rare that I haven't been getting this option very much recently with the previous one, just RNG. And you notice that I do not have a Gravitius on the board, and I'm trying to stick to my strategy. So the Gravitius needs to spawn in. If I remove him, there's a good chance that he does. So there we go, and we have a question mark here. Hopefully it's Gravitius. You're gonna be wondering why I've been mentioning like what happens when it hits 100 up here. So I'd rather show that earlier because there's already a chance that like 99% of people aren't going to make it to this point. So I'm actually going to imprison this guy so that that 21 intelligence is going to feed into here and complete it. Then when I run it, I'll still get two pure stones here, which is like at this point, it's like 5-point-something exalts. And then that in two turns down here will fill up the Katarina, right? Good marker here. So this one is a fortification. Now both these guys kind of suck. Let's see. So, okay, right here, this is very good because now Rin goes from unassigned to going into fortification, right? And the fortification means that she doesn't have a chance of jumping into a house that you really want. So we're getting closer to filling out our bad houses on the left here. The Jorgen option, what is it? It's just plus one rank Jorgen. So actually, I wonder, one thing I'm a little bit unsure on is if this option stays if you do the Jorgen. Since I'm actually not sure on that part, I'm just going to rank her up for the safety option. So there we go, she's assigned, so now she doesn't have a chance of going into like the good houses. And then this one, I don't really need the XP here, so I'm gonna let him go. It wouldn't stay? Okay, yeah, so up to this, right? Come here, okay, hold on. Marker. Alright, so this is a one person on a bad house transportation, but this is, so right here, this is interesting. If you want a Torah in a good house, we have this one ready, then you would want this line, right? You want to create as many lines as you can between bad houses and good houses, of course, but since Torah is eventually going to get moved to the bad houses, I don't want them to have a relationship, and there's no other options, so there's no order of operations to check. So for this one, we don't want, remember, bad houses, you never want to fill up, XP unless you are going to go for a line. So this one I'm just gonna go ahead and let him go. And but now this intervention spawned, okay? So we have a Gravitius and a Corel. So the Gravitius is in the room that we want, so I'm gonna go ahead and rank up my Gravitius right here. And then our Corel, we have Corel and Jorgen. So it's important to note on the board when you see relationships, like if you don't know at first, just look on the board, right? So like Jorgen is right here. So you see, so you walk through the options of, is this a bad house? It is. Since this guy's going to end up in a bad house as well, you don't want a relationship between them. So you wouldn't take this option right here. And because this is intervention XP, it doesn't really matter because it's a 3 XP, which is like nothing. But I guess I like don't want to see him. I'd rather have these guys like having relationships, and imprisoning him, I guess, slightly increases that odds. So I'm going to go and do this. And then I'm going to go ahead and run this. And then I ran this board to make it hard for myself just so I can show the new players what happens when you fill up Katarina and why it matters for the master that you will imprison. And so I'm going to imprison this. And as you can see, I get massive XPs here. So this one will fill up my map, my Katarina. Once again, spoiler alert, if you didn't know, that's Katarina from previous leagues. See, it picks someone to go up. Now, this is kind of a bad scenario once again. And the reason why it's like kind of, it has like a saving grace is because you see this line right here. This line right here makes it so that I will be able to de-rank her kind of reliably with this Verici. So we'll get there. We'll get there. But the bad part about this is that as you see, we are unranked, and like the more unranked people you have, the worse it is early on. But as you can tell by no star, and I can go plus one rank, and then this one would move Richie to intervention, which I don't really want. So what I'm gonna do is I rank him up because he's going to end up in this house anyways. And then this one might have an RNG option on the right side. And so yeah, if the RNG option was drop a map or release. So I mean, early on, I might take a map, right? It's obviously better than just releasing. So we're going to take that. And the map was that fled, and it guarantees her to research. So I'm absolutely going to pick this. But let me just look at the other ones to show you. So, and then also, this one's also moving to research. And then the Hillock is bad, right? Because the Hillock, like, it shifted around because he was on the side, and he's also here. So what I'm going to do with this guy is I'm going to first, just to be safe, right? Because this is my most important master of them all. So I'm just going to go ahead and move him, right? I get a rank, and it's up here, and they're connected, which is really good. And this Ferrucci is going to be next, right? You want to look at this. And look at this. He can go here as well. So the reason you might want to do this is because... you're gonna RNG it if you do this guy first, and you need someone, remember, you need someone watching to get a plus one rank. So I'm gonna move him to research, and then this guy doesn't matter. So I want this guy out. So as you can see, he's one star, which means a interrogation is gonna move him to unranked when he comes out, and then he will have a chance to fill out a bad house. So we do that, and then that is, we're just gonna let him go. Let me explain this Katarina real quick, okay, and why that matters later on. So if we look at the investigation, the reason I scuffed my board a little bit and slowed it down is because I wanted to fill this up to show you. So this means that the Katarina is done. You will never, ever, ever press this button, okay, in your hideout. Like, just don't even put your mouse close to this because you might accidentally click on it, right? Or if you're really bad at clicking, maybe like you move your mouse from the safe house here and you accidentally click on that. But I've seen it happen before. So the safe, definitely not to me though. Now the safe house here, if you run this, it will wipe the entire board, and basically the question marks, the 10 of them that you saw at the beginning of the video, that'll happen again. Completely random people, and you have to do this all over again. The reason you need this full though is because only when this XP is full will it be a one tick to get the master, the leader, out of jail. So this should be a rank up. Yeah. Actually, are they? Okay. So now, like, this house, if the Tor was gone, this would be pretty damn good. Right, because look, you would get the Gravitius, like, two gilded divinations, you get two gilded legion scarabs, with the possibility of like another, like, what, three or four scarabs underneath that. So it's like pretty damn good. But our board isn't set up yet, and the Gravitius, let's see what we have. Oh, okay. So remember, the last guy, we always have an RNG option here, and the RNG that we got was very, very good, and that is that Gravitius and Yannis become trusted. Remember, trusted is a line across the. Right, like, because we know that Yannis will always be in a bad house, this is what we want. And remember what I was talking about before with why would you ever fill up the intelligence in the bad house? Because sometimes you cannot avoid it to get the line. So we're gonna go ahead and pick that. And look at that, lines, both of them are bad, but fortification is a bad house. So let's just take a look. We can rank him up, which is good for XP feeding into the good houses. And oh, and this one's very, very good, because look, Corel right now is unassigned, and what you want to do is you want to take the Corel. And you know that you don't want him in these two houses, right? According to our strategy. So we're just going to move him into fortification, and now he's locked in. And this is great, because if you look at this house right... Oh, never mind, he's not in there. But this is like four people. Like, if he was in here, it'd be a full house, and we need like the other two people in here. So we'll get that eventually. Then we look at the Jorgen, and once again, we don't want any XP. There's no like good options here. So between it, between letting go and bargain, it's the exact same thing. So we're just going to drop a veiled item, because it's better than nothing. Leader, like, very rarely, even without any connectors. We got it that fled. This is... Oh, look at this. We got good RNG option. Once again, good RNG options are always on the right side. And Rin, we know, is in a bad house. And so we want this green line to connect, right? Once again, we get bad intelligence, but it doesn't matter because we gain a really good relationship. And there we go. Spawned either, like, I think this is going to be rivalry, right? What is this? This is... I could get a little bit more... You know, this guy's rank 3, and for the purpose of this, I might get 36 intelligence because that's 96. The Hillock, I do not want him to move to intervention. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to imprison Vagin to get Tora out and unassigned. Let's do that first. And then this one's the RNG option. We got some intelligence here. And I don't want... The reason I don't want to imprison this guy for 3 turns is because I want to encounter him again, right, randomly. Because then I have a chance of assignment into transportation. So here, the XP is good because I'll be at 96. 96 plus 2 is 98. And then maybe I get some other RNG and it fills up the thing a little bit faster. Two man, we got a fortification here. Or sorry, not fortification, transportation. Guff and Hillock are both bad. We we really want this guy. So now this is a great option because Hillock unassigned, we are going to move him into transportation, and now that's a 4-man house. It only needs one more to be completely locked in, so we're going to absolutely move him to transportation. See, he's now in here. Our board is starting to look better and better. The Guff, what's our RNG option? A veiled item, pretty damn good. We don't want the intelligence, and veiled item is better than nothing, so we take the veiled item. That fled in research, that's what we have. So this is a swap. It would swap it that fled and Jorgen in the fortification, and then as you see, they are the same rank. That's why you're getting this option. So if Jorgen was like rank 2, it wouldn't choose Jorgen. So we don't want that because she's in the good house, and we don't want the XP right now. We want to later on, you know, some things might happen with this Ainsley anyway, so we're just going to let her go. Is this one Jorgen? Okay, so we have Jorgen in fortification, bad house, bad master. What is this? Jorgen, it's trying to, okay, so this is like kind of coincidence, right? It's trying to move my it that fled and my Jorgen, so obviously we don't want that. We don't want the bad XP, so we let him go. And the next tick, and I have another tick here, the next tick will complete my intervention. So this one, I don't need to do this imprisonment, I don't think. Do I have someone? Yeah, I don't need to do this imprisonment for XP because sometimes it's hard to remember who's going where, but this is feeding 10 XP into here, which will complete it. And so if we have an option between destroy the items and the let go, obviously destroy items is better because it makes them easier to kill. That'll really only matter at the beginning. Let's see how that feels. All right, let's do this. God, okay, press the wrong button again. Okay. Could you do foothills? Yeah, I could have done foothills, but I have like hundreds of these, so I'm trying to do it like faster, right? I can talk about foothills when it actually matters. Okay, so we got a Verici here. Stream's over again. We got Verici here. It's gonna be, yeah, we don't want a movement. We don't want XP here. We're just gonna let him go. We have, let's see. We can rank him up or anything else. That's about it. We're gonna rank this guy up so that he's safer for XP farming and less chance of being deranked. And then this one, we don't want the XP either. No good RNG option, but drop some currency at the beginning of the league is pretty good because it's always going to be better than let him go. And so he dropped Augment, Scour, and 3 Armor Scraps. And then after the rank ups here. So we want a it that fled rank up. And then... Okay! This is perfect. Let's see. Let me check this one. Yeah. So right here, this for Ricci, I get 2 things. I get a red line, which is good, and a rivalry. I really like that. So I'm going to go ahead and take this. And then the Rin last, we have a drop a unique item. I mean, that's better than letting her go. Because like this XP feed right here, it's not like ready yet, because that's Ainsley in here, and it's only 3 XP. We're going to do that. By himself in a intervention spawn. Which means, let's see, okay, we don't want to take him out once this is a swap, and we don't want to farm for XP, because if you click on this, he becomes, he only has 1 star. We're going to let him go. Why is it so important for a research? And it looks like an unassigned Rin as well. So right here, Rin moves to fortification, really good, and then Tora also moves to fortification. It doesn't really matter here. I guess I'm just going to assign, wait, who has like more connectors? Right now, Rin already has connectors. Which means I would like more, because Tora has no connectors, it looks like. So because I can RNG her on the right side as the last option, I'm gonna move Rin to fortification. And then let's check. And oh, Tora as well. Okay, we got lucky here. Nice. So this is really good because this option right here means that because they all have ranks and they're all assigned here, I really want to get Elrion as a follower, not a leader, but I know I can do that later really easily. And this house is totally full. So all we need to do is we need to drag this Ainsley into transportation, and then we're done. And actually, like, so we can actually start farming XP here. Because once I farm up this, I'll make a red line here. Let's take a look at this one. And this one is Gravitius removed. Okay, so as you can see, these would accomplish different things. Because, like, if it wasn't removal, it'd be the same. But you absolutely don't want to remove. So we're going to take this option here and make them rivals, and then here, drop a unique item is better than let go. So, 2 intelligence. And I don't really care about the breachstone right now, because all I want is to quickly get her out so I can go full potato into these 2 houses. So, wait, no, I can't do this, because if I do this, there's going to be no follower in this room, because they're all assigned, and it's not going to spawn it next time. So this one, I have to let her go. Okay, so we checked like the RNG option and we're gonna let it go. Have you used Vulcan yet? Yeah, my Vulcan's been on for the last 4 hours. So fled, right side option is really bad because we don't want to remove any of the rivalries, and then left side we don't really care about right now, so we're gonna let it go. This one is a Yannis and Gravicius. So here we have a rank up if we need, and Yannis has a rank up as well. For this one, I'm just gonna rank up my Gravicius, and then my Yannis has, we're not gonna remove all rivalries. This is a rank 2, so it's only 21 instead of 36, so I'm just gonna let her go in this instance. Oh, I didn't see him, dude! Oh, okay. So this one, oh, it was transferred. Okay, cool. So this one, let's see, we have Haylock Imprisoned. Wait, let me record here. So we don't want the intelligence, and we don't want this, and there's no like good options, so we're just gonna let him go. We have Hillock, remove all rivals, never gonna do that, never. We don't want the XPs, there's no one else. Okay, this is a Verici by himself. We don't want to remove all rivalries, we don't really want to imprison because he's gonna be unassigned, so we're just gonna let him go as well. Absolutely do sound. Alright, let's do this. Gravicius, once again, bad RNG. We don't really want the XP here, and we don't want to remove rivalries. So let him go. Very well do that, if it's more fun for you, right? Okay, so this one's a Tora in the Fortification. We don't want the XP, we don't want this. None of these are really that good, so we let her go. She will be in here, and then when she comes out, she'll be unassigned. Now, you don't want to do this first, because like this left side option is always an option no matter what, so we gotta look at the other two. So we have It That Fled. Obviously, for this one, I want the It That Fled the most, so I would rank up my It That Fled, and then I look at my Verici, and now this is actually really good. Because if you look at the Ainsley as well, we have a Betray. So we can make him rivals by doing this option, but we don't care about this because we're going to eventually get her out of the house. Because if I click on this, she gets removed. And then the Verici option is better because we get both intel and we get a red line between these two, right? So that is totally fine. We go ahead and Betray, and then she's still there. So what you'll see is that on the left side, we can still interrogate, right? We can always do that. We don't care about this currency here. And then when we do that, they shift up, and now we have a perfect board. It's not really perfect. It means that this Gravicius will probably be a rank up. And yep, and then let's see this one though, just in case. Is it? Yeah, okay, so this is Execute. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna rank up, and we're gonna look at this. Do I want 21 intelligence, or do I want to destroy members? I'm gonna wait for this guy to rank up. Is this a leader? I could take it, but it's not a big deal right now. I'm gonna take that. Cool guy. Okay, let's record here. So we have a Richie spawning by himself in the research, and here, ooh, this is a good option because if you look right here, trusted means that it goes neutral trusted rivalries usually. And so because Hillock is in a bad house, Verici is in a good house, we want a relationship. And since no line exists, we're going to create a line right here. Boom. Oh, looks good. He's unassigned. When we click on this, it's probably going to tell her to go to intervention or something. But what we really want is we want her to spawn with transportation, right? Because we really want her to drag her in here. Because once she gets in there, we are done. And it's time to start ranking up and start farming XP. So for this, I don't really want her in there, but maybe we can get an RNG option. Here, we can farm XP for ourselves, but here I'm not going to do it because if I interrogate him, there's no follower to spawn the intervention, and you'll get two spawns of three. So I'm just going to let this guy go, and then right here, we're never going to remove this, and we don't want we don't want to imprison her because we want her to show up on the next few ticks. Just let her go. My things, not yours. Okay, this one is a Hillock in the transportation. We don't want the XP in any of these forms, so let him go. Verician research by himself, and we have a movement, which we don't want, because these two will never move, these two will never move. So in the future, if you see a movement or a swap, you will never do it, okay? And then we don't want the research from this guy, because he's only rank 1, and that's like no research at all. So we're going to go ahead and keep this guy. This button are once again the same thing, and this one is Ainsley and Hillock become trusted. So this is bad because Hillock and Ainsley are going to end up in the same branches, or they're going to end up on the same side of the board, so we don't want that. So I'm going to let her go. Corel is by himself. We don't want the fortification. We don't want removal of rivalries, right? Oh, we don't want to remove him. So we're going to let him go. You have a, you bring a blanket and muffle the computer so I could like do 56k connection to the internet. Okay, this one I don't care about. I don't care about this one. It's the same thing as last time. We let him go. Okay, so we got a Richie by himself in the research, and we do not want to get intelligence with him yet, and we don't want to move him, so we're gonna let him go. So we're getting very unlucky RNG in these last few, which is like this will happen to you even when you have a perfect board, so don't be discouraged. We have a Yannis and Griffiths spawn again, and this one, my Griffiths is already rank 3, so I'm gonna rank up my Yannis so that next time I can feed the XP at a higher rate. And this Griffiths, we don't want to remove rivalries, we don't care about the XPs, we're gonna let him go. An hour early because it's like such bullshit. Let me record here. Okay, reaching by himself. We have Ainsley to research, which we don't want, and then neutral. So neutral, this option just means that if you see this, it means that they are already rivals. You don't need to look at the line, but you don't want the neutral. You want that line, especially since she's gonna go into the bad house. So we went on the research. We don't want the research intelligence, and we don't want this. So we're gonna let him go. Ever right with he's had a chance to spawn, but he just hasn't because I'm unlucky. If Elrion does spawn, I will actually de-rank him because my strategy, if you saw the beginning of this video, is that Elrion needs to be a follower, and I'll restate why that needs to be. It's because Elrion as a master, especially early on until your board is perfect, is much more rare to spawn than a follower. In fact, he cannot spawn as like the person who creates the branch right in a map. So I need him as a follower to spawn way more Elrion jewelry, because if you get him like, you know, let's get him like 20, 30, 40 times early on League when it's selling for like 20, 30C, 40C maybe, you're going to get a lot more money early on. So that's why I want him as a follower in any house. He doesn't have to be in a specific house to drop his jewelry. So for this one though, once again, we're going to let her go. What patches are coming? No, dude, the patch is out. Alright, here we go. Griffiths spawns by himself. He's already rank 3. And so this one will be pretty easy. This one is a swap or intelligence, so we're just gonna let him go as well. The Richie by himself in research. If you look at the previous few spawns, we've gotten really unlucky, and that feels kind of bad. But here we have another Ainsley Richie neutral, so removing the rivalry and moving her to research. We don't want that, so we're gonna let him go. Okay. Intervention, Griffiths is fine. I missed it earlier. Okay, some good RNG, finally. So right here, we have a Griffiths that spawned by himself, which is usually, as you know, a bad option. You're usually going to end up letting him go. But here, we got some good RNG, and we have Chimeria, which is a bad house member, and it's the leader, so that's pretty cool. So this adds a green line between them, which is very good. You get 4 transportation intel, but it doesn't matter because it's not full, and it's worth the line anyway. So we're going to do this, and look at that, another relationship. All right, individual Jorgen. Double good RNG! Ah, thank you, sir! Okay, so, to explain this one, it's the exact same logic as the previous thing, except for it's reversed. So we have a bad person, so initially you'd be like, oh man, this one's gonna be a release, it's gonna suck, but we got some good RNG here, and now we have a line, trusted means a green line, between Richie and Vagin, and it gets a little bit of research intelligence, which is not bad, because we're getting close, and as long as we can move our Ainsley, we can start doing the juice. So we do this, and look at that, another line. Karel by himself, he's rank 1, we don't want to remove him, we don't want intel for a bad house, so we let him go. Oh, intervention, okay, and, it's 3. Oh man, I saw the Ainsley, I got excited because she's the unranked one, but there is a chance I get an RNG option if I leave her for last. So what I'm going to do is, for this intervention, it's safe to de-rank this person because it's a good combination of 36 intelligence and he's ranked 3, right? So it's like no danger of like de-ranking and unassigning, and so he goes in prison, and then next we go here. And this is an execute. The Ainsley option is an execute as well. So then this one, your options are these two. And see here, since there's no other effect, these two buttons are exactly the same. I'm just gonna click on that. And the Ainsley, so our RNG was like, it wasn't terrible, but like in this situation, we wouldn't do this because Ainsley and Rin would both be in bad houses. We don't want a relationship, so, and we don't want the intel. So it would be great if like this was someone over here, but you know, what can you do? So we're gonna let her go. Your time. Oh man, see, this is gonna try to move Ainsley to research, I think. Yeah. Okay, let's clip this. Okay, so it's a three-man spawn in research, which is very exciting. We have a Richie, which we're gonna rank up. We have a Rin, and we have an Ainsley. So Ainsley's gonna go last because we want to try to get an RNG either relationship or movement. So Richie, obviously, three people means a guaranteed rank one or a plus one rank, and then between these two, we're gonna rank up Rin because she's in a bad house, but higher levels means feeding XP into these two rooms. So rank up, and then the last one is Ainsley. Whoa! I hate Banana 2004. Thank you, man. Appreciate that. And so this one, let's see. We don't want to imprison because we want to counter next, and then we don't want to remove, right? So, yeah. Is there any difference between our orders, correct? Because, yeah, they're both in a bad house, so I actually don't want this rivalry. And, yeah. So D rank here. And now, Corel moves to transportation. This one doesn't matter. And I don't want any intel, so I'm just gonna let him go. There we go. Core button, and I like get this stuff for the video. Okay, so we have a three-man. I forgot if this was intervention or not. Okay. This is intervention, right? Yes. So Gravitius, Chimeria, and Yannis. So Chimeria has plus one rank. That's fine. We can level him up. This person would also have plus one rank. The Gravitius is already ranked up. They're not, the two people that would feed XP at rank 3 aren't rank 3 yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to rank up this guy. And for this person, I'm also going to rank up this person. And now when that leads Gravitius to have an RNG option on the right side, which could be something cool. Okay, it's 14 intelligence. That's like pretty good. So I'll take that because it doesn't like reduce his rank. It doesn't mess anything up. Later on. This one, it's not a betrayal or anything, it's gonna be a rank 1 here, so she will feed more XP as well later on. And then this one, Ainsley and Rin become trusted. Now those are both bad people, so we don't want them. And we don't care about this like 3 intelligence, right? Because we're not ready to run this anyways, so we have to let her go. Once again, we are really relying that we get a transportation on the as one of the spawns. So, and the reason for that is because this is an open house, right? We have a 3 ranks to Jorgen, and then Richie loses our rank. He's unassigned, which is bad. So since I know it's already trusted, and I know I can very easily get this option again, I'm just not going to do anything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at who I want relationships for more for the RNG option. And of course, I want Richie to have more friends, so I'm going to let this guy go first. And the reason you do that is because the RNG option could be beneficial. And look, perfect example. Ooh, okay. It's good that we can show this now. So, because we did the RNG for Verici and we want him to have friends, it happened. See? We got Verici and Gravitius as trusted. So we got a green line in between them. And remember, we want as many lines between the good people to as many other people. We just don't want lines between the bad houses. So this is super good. Like the best thing that probably could have happened. Like either him to him or him to Vagin would have been the best thing to happen. So we go ahead and do it, and now we have a line between these two. Okay, so this one, hold on, I'm gonna quote this. Okay, so we have a Gravitius intervention by himself. The RNG option is bad because it removes him, and we don't really need this. I will talk about one instance here, and that is that if on the next tick, right? Because remember, you're guaranteed like this at least. If on the next tick, sometimes I do D-rank somebody, even when it would force a like a non-spawn, because like, you know, sometimes that's like lazy. But in here, right, setting up, I wouldn't do that. So I'm just gonna go ahead and let him go. Orca intervention, any like strategy, and you just want to run houses any houses over and over and just like randomly get rewards, then I guess you could do that. And like the time you would save initially would cause you to farm maps faster, I guess, sure. Okay, so this one, I'm not ready to run. Hold on, I forgot to record. Okay, so for this one, I'm not ready to run the house yet, right? Because she's unassigned and he's unassigned. So I don't really want to progress this research, right? Because sometimes if I get like a betrayal or like a relationship, I might be forced to get the house intelligence. And having full house intelligence would mean that this one can't spawn. And because there's lines between these two people to other people, that means I can't get those spawn-ins either for better rank ups and better XP farms. So I'm just going to let this guy go. And we have remove all rivals. We never do that. And I don't want intelligence, so easy choice. We let him go. Once again, if you see one dude spawn in, it's usually going to be this is a Gravitius one spawn as well. Let's take a look. Okay, good RNG. So this one right here, we gain a line between Tora and Gravitius, so that's amazing. So we're gonna definitely go ahead and do that. My family name was once synonymous with intelligence. That sounds nothing like ZED. Well, I mean, if he's like voice acting, hold on, let me listen. I don't know. No, I don't think so, right? Okay, so let me record. I don't like how it like repeats this every single time. So right here, bad house, bad master, and we don't want any intel. Let him go. What the hell? Okay, Carol by himself. These are, by now you should probably know that, like, you know, destroy all items doesn't is the same thing as this, so we're gonna do this because we don't want to gain any XPs. This guarantees a red line. So it doesn't have to say Gravitius and Chimeria become rivals. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. And then I still have this option here. And this one, see, we don't want to remove all rivalries because like we just got one. And we have a Chimeria at rank 3. And this is 54. So if we imprison him, like masters give 16 instead of 12. So this is 48 instead of 36. So 48 plus 54 would be a completed house, which we don't really want right now because not everything's set up. So if this completed on the next map, I would have to run it with like an unoptimal, and then this guy would be deranked and unassigned, which is bad. And also if I left it at full, it'd be a few ticks before I could spawn the house again, which is bad again, because then in the next map you only get two, right? You only get one of these and then this one, so you're losing a third of your June. So that's why you do not want this, and you just let him go. Does that make sense? This tile, they could write so much stuff here, but then it just like doesn't say anything. It says betrayal, right? Okay, so this one, let me record. All right, Verucci by himself, rank 3 in intervention, or sorry, in research. So our RNG option is a Ainsley moves to research. We don't want that, and then we don't want our intelligence either, so we're gonna let it go. We still have an Ainsley and an Elrion unassigned. Another quick note, don't pay attention to the height of these things. Like Ainsley, because she's up here doesn't mean she's like a higher rank than Elrion. It's just that this UI is really scuffed and it like puts them in weird places. And this doesn't mean that she's a sign versus someone down here, okay? It's important to note. Yeah. So it's just like Yanni's. So for this one, this Yanni's is 36 plus 54. So this one I'll probably give, this one I'll probably give the juice. So this one it's rank 3, I'm gonna get some intelligence there. So I'm feeling pretty lucky on the next few rounds. And this Gravitius, what do we have? We have execute, wait, hold on. Yeah, and then Elrion is Elrion. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get rid of, Gravitius here, so that we can have him as the last thing. And this one doesn't really matter. I mean, I forgot how much this guy was giving. Was it 36? 36 plus that is 90. 94. And that means that rank 1 will take it 1. So I'll actually just bargain. The bargain let go of the same thing, but it makes that a little bit better in case I get lucky on the next round. Do this. Verici is, we don't want intelligence. And yeah, I'll drop a map, right? Early on, this could be pretty good because like this map, you know, it might be some good one. And then we don't want to let go because this is just overall better in every way than release. So we do that. Himself, we have Ainsley moving to research and then becoming neutral. We don't want that. And we don't want the intelligence, same as always. We'll go ahead and get some Gravitius option. Let's try it out. Gravitius and Yanni. So we did get a good RNG option. It's just not the right. It didn't like roll the right thing. So Gravitius and Yanni's go neutral, which means it removes the red line for no line. And so we'll let him go. I don't sign Jorgen either. And this one, you know, no, I was gonna leave him at trusted. And then the reason I let that guy go first is because now I have an RNG. Option with Verici on the right side. And what's this? Verici moves with Gravitius. Okay, we don't want that one. We were looking for like trusted or to someone else on the board. I'll let him go. Feels bad. Alright, let me do this. All right, Gravicius by himself. We don't want to remove him, and we don't want that, so we're gonna let him go. It better not be a fortification again after this. Getting lucky. Okay. So we have an Ainsley. Obviously, when this happens, it allows her to join the research. I'm getting really bad RNG right now. The Verici and this person, they're in the right positions. Verici as a leader. Itthatflood is a leader. Verici as a follower. So for this one, let's see who has less. Okay, It That Fled has like no relationships. So what I want to do is first I want to do this. And then let's hope for a relationship. Yes! So see, like, my reason is actually paying off. So It That Fled, I left last because of the RNG, because you see she has like she got like nothing, right? Pretty much. So here, It That Fled and my Vagin, which are in the good houses, become trusted. That's a green line, so that's really good. Himself in the fortification. We've gone like a lot of missions without the transport, so this is like kind of scuffed. There's nothing that I would know that is blocking it. We have open stuff here. We have like, you know, people have lines. We have no cap. Like, I don't know what's going on. We'll figure that out later. Right here. Ooh, we got good RNG though. We got good RNG because Corel is in a bad house. So the only lines we want are to people in good houses. And so Corel and That Fled become trusted. That's a green line right there. Gives us a little intelligence as well. There we go. We have It That Fled and a Corel. We can destroy all and make this a red line. So betray, once again, even though it doesn't say that Corel and It That Fled become rivals here, this betray would make that a rivalry, a red line. We don't want intelligence. And the It That Fled option is also betray. And this one, see, this one's bad because this one, it's the same exact thing, except for Corel would lose all ranks, meaning he becomes unassigned, and then that's like very dangerous. So we're going to go ahead and I'm just going to go ahead and betray here. That's fine. And then the It That Fled still has an option. We don't want to remove rivalries, and we don't want fortification intelligence. Let her go. For whatever reason, your strategy, Verici was in a bad house. But for this, we have a betrayal. Ooh. So they're green. 28 intelligence is not a full house, but it's like okay. We're doing max green lines like next time. We're not max, but like a few green lines next time. So for this one. Yeah, I can either do this or this. And so, if you're wondering why you do this option instead of this option, it's because if I did this option, it's feeding intelligence into here, it'd be full, and I wouldn't get this the next round, and then also I'm not ready to run this anyways. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do this, where it's like not full either, and it's like kind of a wash, and then Verici still has a chance of getting some RNG, which he doesn't, and so we don't want to feed the intelligence once again, and we don't want to derank him and get research and challenge. So we're just gonna let him go. We're just wait. Alright, record. Okay, Verici by himself in the research. We don't want intelligence, and we don't want removals of rivalries. Let him go. I was about to get so triggered. I was like, where's Ainsley? Okay, I need an Elrion or an Ainsley to show up with this one after I do this. So this is already max rank, and Verici like doesn't do anything. So I want to RNG Verici. So right here we have well, this doesn't do anything, so we'll do that. And here we go. I'm actually triggered right now. Ainsley! Spawn! Please! Oh, this video is gonna take so long if this keeps happening. Oh. Dude, this is like, this RNG is adding. Okay, this is a Elrion Corel and a fortification. Elrion, this is very good because now we finally have ranked up our Elrion and assigned him permanently to a house. So we're going to go ahead and move him to fortification. That's great. And the Corel, this one's just a bargain, destroy all items, which is doesn't really matter, but our other case is going to let him go. So we're just going to take this option there. Okay, we got Gravicius by himself spawning from intervention. The Gravicius, we can move him to transport, which we don't want, and this is like a swap. Or we can get intervention intelligence, which we also don't want, so we're gonna let him go. Here we have a research rank 3 Verici spawning by himself, drops some currency. We don't want the intel yet until we lock it in. Now, there is a chance that like, if we were to do this, we would have like the house. I mean, there is a chance that, where's our Ainsley? Let's see, can we actually spawn it? We have fortification is okay, we can't spot Ainsley here. So this one I'm just gonna let him go until the next time. Okay, didn't spawn Ainsley here, which we wanted, but we have a Guff and a Yanni's on transportation. This means that that's probably gonna be a rank one. This one's also just nothing here. So we're gonna rank him up so that he's good for feeding intelligence later on in the game here. Execute him. Guff, let's see, Guff and Ainsley become trusted. See, this is actually kind of interesting because if I make, wait. Oh, we got a good RNG option. Wow, it just moves her there. Okay, great. This is like the best RNG we could have gotten. Ainsley moves to transportation. Boom. And the board is done. Let's take a look. Yeah, the board is pretty much done. We have a full house of fortification here. Everyone's in here. Five is max. Five is max here for transportation. And look at that. It's perfect. Everything's done. Now you would just work on building more relationships and more lines. Once again, following the rules of these four good people, you want lines to everything possible, and the people in the bad house, you only really want lines to the good people. So for example, here I'd want to remove this relationship between Ainsley and Guff, but I had to get that right because that last option was that's the only way to pull her in right there. And then you'll start ranking these people up so you can feed intelligence here. So that is done. So we have finished, and let's go track how many it took. I mean, actually I'm gonna go finish the rest of this one though. Okay, so this is a Gravitius Yanni's intervention right here. See, this is what I mean. I can start feeding the intelligence into here, and this is actually like pretty cool because I'll show you what happens here when I do this. When I interrogate, it'll fill up this. I don't care. I don't want to wait until he's rank. I don't care that he's like rank one, because this will move into the master position, and I gotta start building relationships. So I'm gonna feed the intel. He's rank three, and then right here, destroy all intervention items. That's fine as well. Obviously better than the let go. We're gonna do that. Here we have a research. We have Verici and Jorgen. So that means Jorgen, we can betray here. So what would happen here is this green line between Jorgen and Verici would turn into a red. And then as for the Verici here, see, like we can get rivals. We can get rivals and the intelligence. But you know what? For this one, I'm just gonna go with destroy the items because then it fills up the XP a little bit less. And the Verici, we do not want to move him here, and we don't need the XP. We can get that later. So we're going to let him go, and now we have a safe house to do here. Okay, and then after all that, it's time to check how many that took. Remember, we started with 144 of them, because we did a regular tab, which is 12 times 12. And then in my prophecy, I have one here, so we got to add one. So each column is 24, so 4 times 24 is 96. 96 plus this one is 97. 97 plus the one we have here is 98. So it took us, it's 144 minus 98, which is 46. So last time, and that seems pretty fair, because if we look at our board, the last one I did that took like 60, there was a lot more lines. Meaning, like, now that my board is perfectly set up for farming, you know, ranking up the bad houses and then feeding them intelligence into the good houses here, and then on the way you'll just naturally get a ton of lines between these people, right, following the same rules as before. And that was 60 to get a ton of red lines, and that makes sense, because if I do 12 more, what's going to happen is I'm going to just get, let's just say I get on average like 3, right? It's because I don't make any mistakes with the misclicking or anything like that. So that is about, you know, like 36 encounters overall, and that's pretty good. So I hope this video kind of helped. I realize that there's some strategies, like for example the foothills thing I talked about, and other things where like how do you know it's safe to, like, you know, do the thing, or like how do I feed it in properly the XP, and how do I make sure I don't run like safe houses back to back so they don't swap masters. A more advanced video like that with all the examples, just like in this video from scratch, well, from this board, I will also be making in a separate video. But this is just to show from a clean board to a board that's ready to be farmed. This only took 40 something, right? So that should be quite achievable at the beginning of a league, and I'll keep doing this, and we'll keep like reiterating on this. And thank you guys for watching my video. Okay, I hope that helps some of you guys. If you guys have any questions, you guys can ask in the comments, or I guess like if you want to ask me directly live on Twitch every day, I stream every day on Twitch, and you guys can follow me at twitch.tv/qdog_. Okay, bye guys. Thank you guys. Bye.